Alright, so now we're going to show Seifer who's boss. So, you can actually choose between three of these clubs, used in something called a struggle battle. Now, this one prioritizes offense, we'll jump back to that bit later. This one has a handguard, meaning it defends well against attacks, so it's very defensive based. We're going to use a different one, and of course this one, it looks like a stab. You can perform unusual attacks with this. However, if you all watch my Kingdom Hearts 1 Let's Play, you'll know I love to attack straight on. I prioritize offense. It may not be the smartest, most optimal route possible, but you know what? I don't care about optimalness, optimizing my Let's Play. I care about having fun, and I have fun smacking things! Your morale has increased. Strength plus one.
Roxas, focus!
Alright, the gauge in the bottom right is the HP gauge. You lose HP when damage is taken, and the battle is over when HP reaches zero, aka the rule for every single RPG ever. The blue gauge in the bottom right is the MP gauge. It holds a mysterious power that is not yet available. When you approach a target, an orange mark will appear. Press X to attack. Approach and attack Seifer. Gladly. Alright, so Seifer is, of course, very, very basic. He's basically like the first mini-boss in the game. So, after hitting an enemy with an attack, continue attacking to unleash powerful combos. Press X successively. Counter an enemy attack with your own attack to parry and nullify the attack. This action is also useful in a defensive stance.
Come on! Quit playing around and fight!
Defeat Seifer. And of course, as I already said, gladly. Now, Seifer is from Final Fantasy VIII. He is pretty much one of the main antagonists from the game, and I think after a while he ends up being more so an anti-hero as opposed to like a straight-out antagonist. I'm not entirely sure, I haven't really played it in a few years. However, he is the rival of the main protagonist, Squall Leonhardt. However, most of you folks know him in the Kingdom Hearts series as Leon. And with that being said, down goes Seifer.
Seifer's not feeling so hot, you know?
Tournament decides.
Whoa!
What was that?
The thief?
Wow, just typical. Right as we beat Seifer, what do you know? All proof of such has been stolen by this guy who ended up taking Pence's camera. Alright, so let's give the chase to him because you know what? I want to brag to the internet that I can beat Seifer. Because I need that. I really do. Fight the mysterious enemy. Alright, so apparently he has a knack for taking cameras. So we're gonna want to take that camera back, because it has video proof of us defeating Seifer. I mean, despite me recording it on YouTube and everything. And apparently it's not working. Why not? I want to hurt you.
It's no use. What? What is this thing?
Hmm. Well then, that was certainly unique. Our club ended up turning into this key-shaped blade. However, for you folks that have played Kingdom Hearts before, this is aptly named the Keyblade. It is a blade of mysterious and great power, used by Sora in the past. However, what are we doing with it? Get close to grab orbs dropped by enemies when defeated. Yellow orbs increase money, and green orbs restore health.
What's this?
I was his first customer after he took over the shop. So we took a picture together.
It's a really nice photo. Oh.
Hey, you just said photo.
So, Roxas, tell us about the picture thief.
Not much to say. The pictures were just lying there.
Then how do we prove we weren't the ones who took them? It's a girl.
You look happy, Roxas.
Do not.
So, like, anybody else notice that all the stolen pictures are of Roxas?
Oh, so that's why everyone thought it was us.
And Seifer didn't go on accusing us after all.
Are they really all of me?
Yep.
See?
Look.
Right, every single one. Wouldn't it be weird if the thief wanted to steal the real Roxas or something?
Come on, get serious. Why would anyone want to steal a bonehead like Roxas?
Oh, thanks.
Where am I?
Who's there?
Who are you?
Restoration at 12%.
Organization miscreants. They found us.
But why would the nobody steal photographs?
Both are nothing but data to them. The fools could never tell the difference. We are running out of time. Namine must make haste.
Come at you out of nowhere, as long as you continue to wield the Keyblade.
Hey, why don't you come with us? We can go to other worlds on our vessel.
Sora, go with them, especially if you want to find your friends.
Name's Goofy.
I'm Sora. I'll go with you guys.
The Heartless have great fear of the Keyblade.
That's right. The Keyblade.
So, this is the key.
But the boy is a problem. He found one of the keyholes.
A Keyblade? Keyblade. What was that about? Oh! Sorry about that. Thanks.
Do you guys think we'll always be together like this?
I sure hope so.
Huh? Where did that come from?
Well, you know, just thinking out loud.
Well, I doubt we could be together forever. But isn't that what growing up's all about? What's important isn't how often we see each other, but how often we think about each other. Right?
Get that off a fortune cookie?
That's it. No more ice cream for you. Man, today's turning out to be a drag.
Maybe because of yesterday's memory thief.
Nuh-uh. You know what it is? We don't want summer vacation to be over, that's all. So, how about this? We all go to the beach! Why do we go to the beach? Because we haven't gone once this entire vacation. Blue seas, blue skies. Let's just get on the train and go. No? Oh, come on.
Maybe you forgot, but we're broke.
Maybe you forgot I'm smart.
Approach the light to the save reaction command to appear. Press triangle to open a save menu that allows you to save your game. Open the save menu. Alright, so, of course, this is called a save point. And I know, guys, try not to be blown away by Kingdom Hearts 2 innovative technology in saving. Alright, it's pretty much the same old, same old, same saving stuff. I believe Kingdom Hearts 2, though, gives you like 99 slots to save, so I guess that's pretty nice, but overall, you know, same thing. And if you basically go over it, it actually restores Roxas' HP and MP, which is always nice. Hurry up, Roxas. Yeah, yeah. I was teaching my subscribers how to save. We're going to Market Street. And we obtained a Twilight Town map. It's a map of the area. Alright, so, as our good friend said, let's go ahead and go to Market Street.
Just 2 days to go. You and I have to make the finals. That way, no matter who wins, the four of us split the prize.
Okay, you're on. You two are gonna clean up.
Go get him.
It's a promise.
Now, let's get down to business to defeat the Huns. One ticket to the beach is 900 money. How much for four of us? 3,600 money. And 300 each to spend there. What's that for all of us? 1,200 money, a total of 4,800 money. To spend on what? Pretzels, of course. What else is there? Well, there's always watermelon. Too pricey. They're like 2,000 money a piece. Jeez, that is like really expensive. Holy inflation, Batman. Pretzels it is. So, where were we? We need 4,800 money altogether, but all we have is... I've got 800. 650. 150, sorry. That's 1600 money. We need another 3200. Let's find ourselves some odd jobs and earn some dough. We have till the train leaves to earn 800 money each. Meet at the station with cash in hand. Didn't he say he had it covered? Whatever, those pretzels are sounding pretty good. Yes. Yes, they are. Alright. So, now we get to earn money. Which is, ironically enough, the name of the currency in this game. Right. So, Ruxus's journal contains hints of what to do next in past events. So if you ever get stuck, of course, you can go look at that in the main menu under Journal. Alright, so there are three odd jobs here. I will show each one, and then I guess we'll just kind of leave it off there. So, first and foremost, the mail delivery. I need someone to deliver some letters for me. Now, I will say, I am terrible at this minigame. I don't know why it is. Like, you know, it's not even that the minigame's broken or anything. It's just, I'm really bad at it. Just, like, really, really bad. Like, none of my friends have had, like, any issues. And it's just, I don't know, man. And, there we go. Oh, see, basically, what you have to do is that you have to kind of, like, you have to change your targeting on the fly. So, there you go. I managed to do it in 1613, but even then, you guys saw it was pretty shaky. Thanks, you're a big help. Received 50 money. Yeah, unfortunately, this tends to take a while because it gets... Because I think the max money you can get from, like, one job is 50 money, regardless of how well you do. So this part gets a bit grindy, hence why I'm only showing each minigame once and then we're just gonna end the episode. So for this one, Cargo Climb. This one's actually probably the easiest in my opinion, except of course I'm messing it up, but basically what you have to do is kind of hit at it from behind, and then when it goes in the air, you want to hit it again in midair, because then it'll go flying forward. So just kind of, it's an extra boost, all right? So let's just go ahead and hit that forward, and now we can pretty much do this in like 20-something seconds. And ironically enough, the cart breaks once it gets in the garage, but not our problem anymore. Let's see, good job. And so we received 50 money! Yes, 50 money. Okay, come on. So, the next game, or the last minigame, Grandstander. You want to be famous? Looking for someone to put on a great street performance. Let's choose this job. Alright. So, for this minigame, basically what we have to do is we have to keep the minigame in the air as long as we can, basically. Or, kind of like... build up our hit combos. Unfortunately, I kind of messed up there, and you only get, like, 5 tries, so if it hits the ground 5 times, then, you know, you're out of luck. So, what I find to be the easiest, if I can do it, is just kind of stick to a corner, and, you know, that kind of helps it stay up, and of course I mess up there. Alright, come on! Yes! Okay, and of course I mess up, but it's pretty easy to get to rack up combos to, like, 50, 60, if you're that good, but the only problem with that is that the ball tends to go all over the place, so it can get pretty tricky, but otherwise, it's not that bad. Alright, but unfortunately, we get paid little to nothing for doing all these odd jobs. So, I think we're going to cut the episode off here. In the next episode, I'm going to have all the money, and we're going to go to the beach! Alright, so this is GrandPyromania signing out. I will see you guys.